Back here in the Mid-South, Shelby County's tax assessor says his office is short-staffed and is in desperate need of more boots on the ground.
Assessor Melvin Burgess says he's found more than $7 million in potential revenue for Shelby County, and he plans to present those findings to county commissioners this week. But first, he's here to explain what this all means. Good to have you.
Welcome back.
Last time you were on the Live at 9, we talked about this. First of all, where might this $7 million come from? Explain that to our viewers again.
It could come from several places. One, we've already identified expiring pallets.
Okay.
These are pallets that's been on the roll, and now they are expired.
Tax breaks for companies coming
exactly.
here.
Exactly. And right. once they expire, we can put those right back on the roll as, you know, per the statute.
So when they expire, what does that mean to the average taxpayer out there who's trying to figure out what this is all about?
Well, I mean, when we put them back on, that means some of the burden comes off of you, because right now we're working under capacity, less than 50% when it comes to appraisers. The state statute said for every 4,500 parcels that we have, I should have one appraiser. And at this point, I only have 42. Hmm. So I am short 44 appraisers.
So yeah, basically,
you've been quoted as saying, though, almost $7 million is being kind of in property taxes are being left on the table. What's the deal there?
That's because we got pallets that are finna expire. We have permits. We have a permit department where when you go and do an addition to your home, mm-hmm. well, you have to file a permit. That comes to our office. Well, we have over 3,000 permits that comes in a year. Mm-hmm. By me being understaffed, I can only look at about 400 of those. That's money gotcha. Being left on the table right there.
Because when you expand your house, you would owe more property taxes.
That's
if
right.
you improve it or expand
That's
it,
right.
right? You raise its value.
That's
so
right.
basically, what you need to ask county commission for is more money for how many employees? What are you going to ask them for Wednesday?
Well, when I came over to the assessor's office, we had 23 clerical positions that were open. I don't need no clerical people. I can take 20 of those I have already identified in our office, and we can build their career to be appraisers. Mm. And okay. I gave up the IT department to offset the costs to how can I train them? I can certify them. You got to be certified and have special training to be an appraiser, because okay. we're always dealing with appeal attorneys, people who appeal, you know, their assessment.
Now, gotcha. Just in the past week or so, we've been hearing a lot about Shelby County Mayor Lee Harris's budget. Uh-huh. What about the mayor's budget? What does it call for your office? Does it provide any relief whatsoever, or maybe not?
It calls for no relief. I think at the end of the day, I was only given $25,000. That is not make my office full. When I got to that office is working under 50% capacity. That office has not asked for an increase in their O&M in 6 and 7 years. So Alex, I'm just trying to bring it back to where it needs to be per the statute. Because mm-hmm. by statute and by law, it says that that office has to be up and running. I cannot put all of the burden on the homeowner right now. Is all the burden has been put on the homeowner.
So going from the mayor's office to the county commission, of course, you're a former county
That's
commissioner
right.
yourself.
That's right.
Do you feel as if you can get the support there that you need?
Well, I'm hoping so. You know, I hope I'm laying my case out, you know, to ensure that we get the money, because we need the money for the schools, we need the money for the sheriff's department, we need the funds. The money is there, and it's a win-win situation for everyone. But what I want to stress is this, is that we have to be equitably looking at everyone, commercial, real estate, personal property. We just cannot put it all on the homeowner. And that's what's happening with this program now. It's all been put on the homeowner.
So you could make the case that, because we had Jim Strickland, Memphis Mayor Jim
sure,
Strickland
sure.
on last week, who said we don't want to charge individual homeowners more property tax. What we want to do is expand
that's right.
our base by bringing more people. Do you think this move could stop some of the flow of people out of Memphis?
Well, the question I always ask is this. I tell the pilot, people that work the pilots, both mayors, is this. When we give the money out to pilots, show me as the assessor and the trustee, how do we bring it back?
Gotcha.
It's like you're saving money for your kids' education, college education, and every so month you take money out, and then when it's time to go, then the money's not there.
So very quickly, I wanted to know about the future of pilots
sure.
with companies like Electrolux
sure.
and so many others
sure.
and whether everybody's going to be paying their
sure.
their fair share. Where
sure.
do you think we stand there to attract business?
You know, and when I said earlier, when I came on earlier some months ago, I said we're not over-piloted. I'm not against pilots. All I'm asking you is this. When we give a pilot out, please, I would like to be at the table, myself and the trustee, to make sure it's equitable and we got a plan to bring the money back. to the county.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Real quickly, you said potentially $7 million could come back in. What are you going to be asking county commissioners for? What would it cost the county to bring your staff up
I'm
to speed?
I'm asking for $600,000. And out of that, we gave up my IT department, which was $500,000. So I was only asking for a little over $100,000.
So essentially it's $100,000 to get
right.
$7 million.
Right.
Potentially.
Burgess, thank you very much for
thank
giving
you,
us
Alex,
that update. We appreciate it.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Keep
thank
us up to date, please.
Thank you.